What's up? Welcome to day 247, Make It Song Bringer. I'm pretty excited because I got this this post finally finished about making this how to do a Kickstarter, basically. Actually, the real point behind this whole article is that you should prove that your game is worth the time that you put into it before you make it, before you fully make it. For example, typically developers will spend a whole year or 2 years making a video game. And the problem is, if you haven't proved that people will... If your goal is to make money with the game, and you haven't proved that people will buy your game, that's a big problem. And crowdfunding can solve that. So I wrote an article about it. I put it on Gamma Sutra. It's on the homepage right now. If you just go to gammasutra.com. What's up, Marza? Welcome to the stream, man. Sorry it's so late for you. Sorry I've been getting doing late streams lately. But yeah, if you want to go check out the article, there's two things in this article. One is about that whole topic of how to prove that your game is worth your time. And secondly, it tells you how to run a crowdfunding campaign. So if anybody's interested in that, it's right here on the homepage of Gamma Sutra. Just click it right here. It's my pink sword dude icon. What up, Alex Pita? So yeah, I'm actually pretty excited to have an article finally on Gamma Sutra, and secondly, to finally have that article done about how to do a Kickstarter, because I've been promising it for so long. So I put it up on Gamma Sutra, and tomorrow I'll be promoting it. And so you people that are that are watching the stream and everything, you'll get the link eventually, I'm sure. Yeah, right. You see that? King got bought by Activision. What's up, Kofez? Yeah, that's pretty big. Activision Blizzard bought King.com, which is huge, for $6 billion. $6 billion. I think that's more than they sold the Star Wars franchise. Wait, no. How much did they sell the Star Wars franchise for? No, I was thinking of Minecraft. Minecraft sold for like $4 billion. King sold for $6 billion. I think, didn't Disney buy Star Wars for $12 billion or something like that? Dude, entertainment is a big business. That's what we are. As game developers, we are in the entertainment business. So yesterday's stream, I had created four new enemy behaviors. And the fourth one I was unable to finish it during the stream, the actual behavior part of it, because it requires some new logic. WhatsApp sold for $20 billion? Holy crap. I've never even used this app. Yeah. Man, it's big business, right? Big business. I mean, I don't feel like I'm in the business of big business, but I guess I technically am. I'm a small guy in a big, huge pond. But, you know, maybe I'll get bigger if I keep eating stuff. Right? So, yeah. So, okay. I got four different new enemies in the game. And, it will crash if I run this one. Not crash. It'll just assert fail because it's like, dude, I can't run that behavior yet. So the goal for today is to finish the behavior for this fourth guy. So this is the third guy. He walks around and shoots diagonally. I just have gray squares for now, representing the enemies, because all I'm trying to do is finish the behaviors before I do the art. So this last guy, I got a clue for how to do this. So basically, this last guy's AI, he's the kind of guy that walks around and around things. What's up, Rocket Bunny? So for example, if he were to go, if he were to walk, yeah, I'll like walk around and show you what. Yep, still wild cinder blocks. Yep. Boogie called them wild cinder blocks. He said it really funny too. He's like, a wild cinder block approaches. Right? So yeah, so this last guy will work like this. And let's say the player is one of these enemies. So what he would do is, if he starts here, he would start with a random direction, start walking. As soon as he hits something, he starts walking around and around it. That's all this enemy is gonna do, is just walk around and around and around stuff. And you know, as things get bigger, like if it was the edge of the screen, he would walk all around this edge, and then over here, and then Not up there, but around this edge. So you get the point. So that's the goal for today. I've got this almost working. These are I mean, I've got it outlined how this will basically work as far as the AI goes, the behavior tree. I just need to get in here and finish this so we can actually parse these kind of behaviors. So it's a tricky, this is one of the trickiest AI I've written so far because it needs to check what is around it. It needs to know what it's touching. So, you know, that would keep it looping around and around stuff or walking around an edge or whatever. It needs to know that there's a wall to the left or some kind of collision to the left or the right, or north, south, whatever. So that's the concept. That's what we're working on today. So I'm going to start writing with it. The goal here is to make it so the collision... actually, let's decide what component is going to be. Pretty sure, yeah, I want to put this as a part of collision components. They already have flags. But I think I'm going to make this touching. So this is going to be an array of touching. EIDs, yeah, EIDs. So this will be smart in a couple different ways. It will know that it will know what's around it, what it's touching, and it will also know what entity ID that is too. So this could be pretty advanced at some point. You know, this would be very smart. An entity can know not only that it's touching something, but it can know what it's touching. So EID, we're just gonna call this touching. And this is going to be K max number of directions. What is that? Num directions? I don't even know what this is. Okay, num compassers. That's it. 8 + 2 for counter and clockwise. And then we're also going to have last touching. So this is the last frame. Same exact thing. There we go. Okay, so the collision components are all going to have these stored in them. Wait, let's make sure that this is going to work right when we tick the systems. The collision system ticks before the move to system. Damn. I wanted this to, okay, so the, because the move system needs to move the entities first, and then the collision system needs to call to see what it's touching. Rocket Bunny, I just said that. I just told, I'm working on, this guy that walks around and around stuff. You were here for last stream, remember that? He walks around and around and around. And that's why I'm creating components and things like that that will do that. So, component. Oh man, yeah, the tick. What am I gonna do this? So the collision system ticks once, and then the move system ticks. No worries, man. No worries. This is either gonna have to be sort of retroactive, like. It only knows what it did last frame. That's not right. No, we could do a collision system. I guess we could add another collision system sort of tick, or inside move system. Now that we moved something, we could do collision system update. Ah, yeah. There's a way. First, I'll get this part done with the component. So we got an array of different compass directions plus 2 for counter and clockwise, and we need to fill those up. So in the system for collision system, we also need a flag. We need a flag, a collision component flag, which says, I need to know what is touching me. I need to know what's touching me. It's funny to say. So collisionize, right? All these kind of things. So now we have a flag for tracking whether we're touching stuff. Because this is going to be sort of complex. There's going to need to be maybe 8 different calls to the collision system to see, you know, what's around it. This is going to be an expensive operation. That's why I'm adding a flag and only doing it for entities that specifically say, I need to track touching. System is going to need a function that goes through each one, each one of the directions, and basically updates the touching. So man, I'm debating whether this should be a whole array. Whether it should go over every single one of these, or whether it should just go over one. If I do it like this, this probably could be good. Because then we could tick touching after we do the movement. Actually, this sounds the most proper to me. Yeah, we'll tick touching. Like that. Okay, so now in the tick, we need to call that. Oh, and this. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Okay, I changed my mind. This should probably take a delta. No, fix delta. Yeah. Okay. So it takes a fixed delta. Even though I'm probably not going to use it. Best to just keep this all. Right, so this is after we've moved, we update the tick, the touching. Yeah, they don't have one by default. What you got to do is you got to schedule an update. So in your my system works totally different than I'm trying to. It's than what's simple. Let me think of it. There's got to be a scene I could show you. Overworld layer? Yeah, hair. No, that's... Dude, I wish I could show you something simple, but my code was totally different. But basically, you schedule your own update. What's up, Pedro? So let me show you how that would work, right? If you were to create a layer class, you would need to create an update method like this. Overworld layer update. What's up, Blood? So Kofez, you do this. Basically, at the end of your on enter, or perhaps in the constructor, whatever you want to do, you would call in a scene or a layer, you would call this schedule update. And my autocomplete is not working. But yeah, here we go. See, schedule update. Bam. That's how you get it. Or you can call schedule with your own method, right? This schedule. Are you getting this? Are you listening? You watched 3 seasons of Parks and Rec in 2 days? Crazy. Yeah, I love my favorite. Who's your favorite character? It's going good, man. Yeah, it's going good, bud. I'm working on those. That right where I left off yesterday, I'm right back in it. I'm still working on the system for that. I've been working on a lot of other stuff lately. And also, you guys just joined the stream. I got this article on Gama Sutra that I wrote about how to do your own successful Kickstarter, and also how to prove that your game is worth the time before you spend years making it. And that's if you want to make money doing it. No, I haven't. Okay. All right. So back where we were, where were we? Tick touching. Here we go. Right. Tick what this entity is touching after we move. So this is a whole new collision system function we're going to create. Oh yeah, damn. Well, you catch up on some Parks and Rec. So we'll go to the collision system and make this new function for ticking. Actually, this would probably be. Here. Oh, also the component needs to erase this before it ever creates it. So, collision component. Loop over all the directions and all that. All right, nice. You can't like work at it. I know what you mean. How long do you got? How long do you got till you can start standing up and working and all that kind of stuff? We got the default constructor, which erases all that. All right, now this collision system can go and update them. Evermore, no, I don't know. I couldn't think of any way. Yesterday's stream, there's a lot of thought that went into that. I think you were there, right? But yeah, this is necessary. This is necessary to create this AI this way. And yes, I will probably use this again for something else. All right, so in the system, tick touching, we'll go over every entity. And test if it has this flag, then we'll do its tick touching and all that. Ah. Did it turn out all right? How'd it go? Ah. Mm-hmm. Cool, man. Awesome. So if this thing has the flag that we're looking for, collision track touching, we're going to update all this. First thing we want to do is loop over the touching and store the last one. Hello, Jimmy. So it'd be way more efficient to only get the collision component here. Overall, this will be more efficient. So then we can just actually check all this right here and then create an entity if we need it. Or an int, I mean. Int only if you need it. That'll be a lot more efficient. We don't have to do that twice for every entity. Okay, oh, actually, it'd probably be best to just do this simpler like this. If not, continue. I don't like to indent if I don't have to. I think it makes code a little more maintainable. Oh, nice. No problems. Right. Yeah, I hear you. I've had many moments like that myself over my years coding and stuff. So, all right, so we want to store the last touching. Last touching I is collision touching I. There we go. So we got the last touching. Now we're going to update the actual touching for this entity. So we need to go and check for each direction we're in. So we'll start there. And we would want to do something like this, like auto sid or no. Collision id equals collision system get collisions or just get collisions fine for entity e.id mask. Is this move mask or is it collision mask? I don't think collision has a mask. It does. I think it's move mask though. Oh, man. Oh, I hate things that are unclear. Ah. I wish I knew. Yeah, dude. It happens to me, too. Did you try the basics though? Did you try restarting Xcode and also restarting your computer? Sometimes that helps me, but I know what you mean, man. One tip I have is to maybe try and take away everything out of your project that you don't need. In fact, I even took out Cocos2DX from this project's I took out the project files of Cocos2DX so it wouldn't have to compile them, but that didn't actually work because it still has to go and scan all the headers anyways. So I don't know. Maybe just try and simplify your project and restart. It's my only... Yeah. Yeah, so maybe just try and simplify your project then. True, right? Okay, yeah, it's the move mask. This one's the collision mask. When it only when we want to collide and damage other entities, we use the collision mask. That's right. Okay, so we want to get this thing's use this move mask and this thing's current position. So E dot position dot pause and its size. E dot collision dot size. There. Right? So this thing is going to use its move mask, its position, and its size to determine if there's a collision. And this is going to be for every compass direction. For now, we're just using dir equals I. Oh, we need to change its position. So we need a, okay, we need a position. V3 at pause. So depending on the direction, we're going to set a position. Right, and then so we'll switch the dir. Yes, yeah, I do use a pre-compiled version of Cocos3DX, but that's just the library, not all headers, of course. That's why mine's slow, too. I'm pretty sure it's because of Cocos3DX is so huge. What's up, Manic? All right, so for East, yeah, all right. So let's get the direction. If it's num compass dirs, then the direction is actually going to be, this is the clockwise direction. Oh, I don't like this now. Wish there was an easier way to do this. Okay, right, we got north, but we don't have like, it might be best to actually create another set of directions specifically for these. Yeah, I think that's better. Hey, what's up, Sumis? Man, I haven't seen your name in a while. Hope you've been good, man. How's your game going? Yeah, it's best to do this with its own directions, because we need clockwise and counterclockwise, and I'm thinking we might not need all 8 compass directions. Really, we can test to the north, south, east, and west. Well, do we really need to test northwest, east, you know, southwest, all these diagonal directions? Oh, all right. Are you tattooing or what? Uh-huh. Yeah, so we'll call them touching flags. Okay, touching north. No, actually, I think south should be the first direction. It's usually what I do in the rest of the code. So south, west, northeast, clockwise, counterclockwise, num directions, or num. Actually, this could just be const int knum touching directions is equal to k, the last one. So south, west, north, east, clockwise, counterclockwise. So the total is going to be k touching counterclockwise plus one. There. This is going to be better. Better to have this all explicit and simple and all ready for this one system to work. All right, man. All right, Marza, good night, man. Couldn't you just do a left right hand rule behavior as soon as the guy runs into a wall? No, it's not that simple. It's not that simple. Let me show you Evermore exactly what I'm trying to do here. I'll draw it for you. If I do a new image, we can see. Here's why that would not work. And this is kind of covered last stream, but let me show you. Anyways, let's say there's a wall right in the middle of the screen. All right, so you're saying, why can't they just turn into a left-right type thing? Watch this. Let's say he starts here, right? An entity starts here. He moves towards this wall. He hits the wall, okay? He's stuck. Bam, he realizes, oh, I need to go into that whatever behavior, like you're just saying. Okay, great. Let's say he starts walking along this wall. He starts going north in. All right, great. How the hell is he supposed to know to turn right as soon as he gets past this? He needs to know what is touching in order to be able to turn at this point, right? That's this little tiny turn right here is why I'm writing this whole system. I hope that makes sense. But if it doesn't, let me know and I'll try and explain it a little better. Alright, so we're gonna loop over instead of, oh yeah. Forgot to update the component. So these are gonna be knum touching dirs. What was it? Touching dirs? Yeah, touching dirs. Alright, let's get that compiling now. Touching, last touching, yeah. I don't think we hate Israel. Okay. All right. Nice. Nice. He is. Marza is from the future. We've established this. Okay. All right. So this one, we need to loop over the number of touching directions instead of the compasters. Much better. I hated that plus two right there. That was really bugging me. So this is really great that now this is written with that nice specific constant. All right, so we'll go back and here also, we want to loop over the touching dirs. And now we don't need to worry about the direction being weird or anything. So I is just the direction. The position will change a little bit. So, K-Touching South, we'll start with. Pause. This is really easy. Pause dot y minus minus. Or minus equals 1, maybe. Right? Oh, this is switch I. Still won't work, Evermore. Yeah, he needs to know. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter even if he spawns right next to the circle. That won't help. Check this out. Let's say he spawns right next to the circle. Okay, that's great. And let's say he already knows that he needs to start walking north. Magically. All right, great. He starts walking north. Same damn thing. He needs to know that there's a wall to his right that he needs to turn at when he gets to this point. Otherwise, he'll just keep walking and walking and walking. Does it make sense yet? Thanks, man. Final release? No, I don't know. It's going to be 2016. I was shooting for March, but now I don't know if I can even make March. So I don't have any final release date exactly. But it's going to be, it's definitely going to be 2016. Me too. Yeah, very tolerant, right? You guys in the Netherlands are so tolerant. Wow, you like it in winter? Cool. You guys probably get a lot of snow up there, huh? Oh, yeah, this is ambiguous. All right. Yeah. That's clear now. All right, so this is just going to be touching. Touching I equals this collision. So this is going to be get the collision for that touching direction. All right, now we just need to flesh out the rest of these directions. All right, man, cool. Nice. Except immigrants? Yeah? Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. I hear ya. Damn, sorry about that, man. I wish I had a magic solution to make Twitch instantaneous and awesome for everybody. But other than time traveling forward 4 years in the future or something like that, so we have better internet. Why did I say 4 years? I don't know how many years it's going to be. We should ask Marza. Marza would know. So we'll do east-west. East is going to be x plus 1. West is minus 1. Awesome, man. How to make it instantaneous? Don't use Twitch. Wait. There's a streaming thing called Hitbox and it's instant? No way. Really? Is that for real? Is Twitch really just lame and I didn't know that? Wait, redbull.com is commenting on Hitbox versus Twitch? Which is better for a new fish? That's right. Wow, so this guy's commenting as well. It's like, oh, it's instantaneous. Okay, if Hitbox is instantaneous, then why the hell isn't Twitch trying to make their shit better? What's up, Boogie? Yeah, Hitbox has its lack of delay. Yeah, we already got YouTube Gaming. Wow, dude, I never even heard of it Hitbox before. Yeah. Oh, Boogie, so yesterday we were talking about all those walls and stuff, and I'm implementing it now. And good job, dude, implementing yours last night. Dude, you did it so fast. Yeah, it is. I know, it's like, I don't know if I can even really switch at this point, because I already have a following built here on Twitch, but, I mean, I guess I could jump ship and start over if Hitbox is really that great. I don't know. What's up, Grim Gary? Okay, so I'm working on yeah, nice. You want me to stay at Twitch? Alright, alright. Stay with the delay, man. It takes you guys like 10 seconds or whatever it is, or 30 seconds to a minute even sometimes. But I see sometimes that could be what you need. All right, this needs to be some kind of either a lambda function. Yeah, a lambda function would work. Is that right? Is that the right thing to do? Create a lambda function right here? Who cares? Autofunc equals takes in a direction. Oh, one thing we should do is make sure these constants are strongly typed. Touching dir. Oh, Twitch has multi-stream. What's up, Azarus? Yeah. You want me to do two streams a day? Yeah, exactly. I would love it if they did, though. Seriously, if Hitbox can write something where somebody's live streaming and there's instantaneous chatting, why the hell can't Twitch? I'm sure they can, right? If there's a service out there that's doing it, that's proof enough. Scott, the idea guy, music! You want music? Sorry, man. I can't put on music on my stream because I upload these to YouTube and YouTube flags them for music. So sorry. Wish I could. Mm-hmm. Oh, they can't do it because they don't have the users. Now that makes sense. Thank you. Thanks for explaining this to me. Oh no, did I break everything? Looks like I did. Oh no, this is fine. Okay, so we'll take a direction now. Take a touching dir. And a position. So this is gonna be get pause. That's fine. And we take a v3f. Switch the dir, added the pause. That's it. Nothing like that. Oh, yeah. So we're gonna break here. We don't need that. Pause equals get pause, and then we're gonna, well, now we call it get pause. So this is passing in the direction, and the pause. Okay, so now that we got this lambda function written, we can actually do the smarter thing, which is gonna be, we're gonna test. So if this is the counterclockwise direction, we need to base it, or like clockwise and counterclockwise are gonna be based on the entity's current direction. So the entity's current direction, that's gonna be eve.move.compassDir. Now if the, So we don't even need that. We can go if I equals K touching clockwise, then we base this off of, see what I'm saying? We'll get that finished in a sec. Scott the idea guy, is the name final? Do you mean the name of the game? Everyone needs a strong back end. I don't know. That's a good question, Evermore. Really good question. Yeah. So, Vlad, what's your delay right now? How long does it take you to get your messages across? Scott, the idea guy. Yes, it pretty much is. I've already done a Kickstarter. I've already got it on Steam. So, I don't know. I can't really change the name of the game. And actually, there's no way in hell I could change the name of the game now. Why do you say that, though? Is you not like the name? What's up? Yeah. 10 seconds for you, but you're in Brazil? That's great. Oh, no, you're not in Brazil. Sorry. I know you're in Portugal. Oh, man. There. Wake up. Yeah, so you're in Portugal and you only got 10 seconds? That's great. I know. Sorry. My bad. I'm embarrassed now. A minute, whoa. All right, so this is going to be touching dir based on the last, oh man, now we need a function that takes a touching a direction and turns it into a touching direction. We'll don't try it. Auto get dir based on a touching dir. No, based on a compass dir. Or an int, whatever. Int d. So we'll switch it, get it. Based on e.move.compassDir. Yeah. I don't know if I haven't seen anybody ever get under like 4 or 5 seconds. So for if it's clockwise, we need to base that off of the compass dir and add. Okay, so clockwise, Oh man, so this is tricky, super tricky, because we need to add. We need to add two for some directions and when one for some other directions. I guess we could just go clockwise. And call this modified dir or whatever and go bool clockwise. And then switch them all. That would be really, really easy, actually. Yeah, that'll work. Switch D. Buffering every minute? Damn. Probably a shark nibbling on underwater cables. Yeah, this happens a lot, actually. Big tournaments. And also, like, when there was TwitchCon, forget it. But at least, hey, at least all the bots are gone. Dude, for like weeks, I was getting 4 bots a day or whatever. More than that. And now there's no more bots. That's freaking awesome. Yay, thank you, Twitch. Thanks for getting rid of the bots. Or maybe the bots just finally gave up. I don't know. They're like, nobody's listening. So, K, dir, like if it's, whatever. We'll do every one of these dirs. South. Clockwise from south is going to be K touching west, right? Clockwise, yeah, west. Otherwise, east. There. All right, so southwest. Clockwise, same thing. Oh, but southwest, the clockwise, counterclockwise would be south. This is kind of tricky. I'm glad I'm actually doing it this way. All right, so then west, same kind of thing where it's like north clockwise, south the other way. Man, this is a long stream just to get without even running the game, but sorry guys, I have to get all this done before I can compile. So north, south, right? Clockwise is north. Yeah, these are good. So northwest, we gotta have north and west. North, clockwise is gonna be east. And then, yeah, west. So northeast, east, and north. East, south, north, last one, southeast, clockwise is south, counterclockwise is east. There we go, man. So we needed all that for clockwise, get pause, modified dir. This is going to be bool. Clockwise is true for this one. All right. Almost done. Almost. Counterclockwise. False. I think I think that's done. Let's run the game. It's gonna crash anyways. This is my favorite. I love it. I love Link Champ. It's like, I got the Triforce. Check it out. Oh man, still this is gonna fail. The system's gonna fail because the behaviors aren't hooked up yet. So, oh wait, but I think I already fixed it. Anyways, I can finally run the game. If there's anybody running, you just joined the stream, you're like, what the hell is this? What does this game even look like? I'm about to finally show you. Oh, but we are going to need some new behaviors after this. Before we can yeah, so we'll need to do a couple different new behavior types. So yeah, this is the game. It's called Songbringer. It's like Zelda. These little wild cinder blocks here are the new enemies I'm creating. So these are like some existing enemies right here. There's an overworld just like Zelda. There's an underworld where you got all these different levels. There's 9 different levels. There's tons of secrets, lots of items. Game's coming out in 2016. Anyways, let me get back to this. Now we need a couple behaviors. They're in their natural habitat. All right, so we're looking at this guy right here. And now I need to hook up some words to the dictionary for parsing the behavior tree so that I can process this. Like if the last collision, but this is different now that we got the touching. If this is going to be if last touching counter not touching. I guess we could do touching. Nah. Thanks, Hero. Yeah, this will work. This is fine. Duraclockwise, we're gonna need to add that though. Counter. All right, so bear with me. There's a lot more to do to get this working with this system. But once it's done, there's going to be a lot of stuff that can be done with this new system. First of all, it's probably best to get in these behaviors. So let's go to the behavior types. We need a bunch more of these, more words. Clockwise and counterclockwise. How long have I been in indie development? Well, I mean, the term for indie development really has only blossomed in the last, 5 or 10 years. So, yet the entire time, I've been an indie game developer since 1994 when I started making video games in high school. So, yeah, so really I've been in indie development for more like 20 plus years. But not the entire time. I took a long break and didn't make games. I didn't program anything at all for years because I was so tired of it. I'm like, dude, I hate programming. But then I realized, dude, I love programming after I'd taken a nice long break and just got back to what was really important to me too. So you know what I mean? Like when you make games for other people, if you're working in a game development company, it can suck if you're one of those people that really wants to make your own game. And that's all I wanted my whole life. I wanted to make my own video games. And so when I worked for other people, it sucked. And I had to take the time to learn that, you know, I like bust tables for years and stuff. Yeah, I'm one of these old people. Very old. I'm ancient. I got a beard. I just shaved it off. No, I'm joking. My beard has a plateau. Never gets past it. It's funny. Now we need the collision, the last or touching, last touching. K behavior touching. Last touching and not touching. And not last touching. Wow, there's a lot of those. I guess like you know what? All these knots, it'd probably be better to not do these like that. So it'd be better to go like this. Like if last touching, counter. If touching, not counter. Yeah, that simplifies it a lot. We only need two different constants for behaviors now. Touching and last touching and not. Can't believe I don't have not yet. Right. Touching, last touching, clockwise, counterclockwise, and not. Those are all the words we're going to need to add to this. Nice, right on. Nice, man. I do too. I do too. Wow. Grand Theft's been since 1997? Wow, this is a really in-depth article here. How do you even track that? I definitely have shirts for sure. I know I have underwear. That's older than 7 years, right? Don't I? I definitely have socks. I have socks from the 90s still. I can't believe they don't have holes in them. How the hell did that happen? How do socks last 20 years without getting holes in them? They're like indestructible socks. So now we need the words hooked up for these behaviors. We got not. None, any, not. Okay, so the last four words. And I guess we can add some more words for these too. Like counter can be counter, counterclockwise. Clockwise could be also just CW if you want to get shorter sometime. And this could be CCW. Clockwise, clockwise, counter, 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 touching, last touching. Looks like we got the words we need. What's up, Mr. Tim? Yeah. No, I'm not actually from California. I'm from Oregon, which is just a state up to the north. Okay, all right, we got these new dictionary words. Now it's time to hook them up so the system works for this. Yeah, they're already parsed. We just need to go and go into the system and hook them up into the AI. Well, actually, you know what? I need to test if this is even working now, this tick touching method. Right? This should never, ever be called at this point. Let's set a breakpoint there and make sure that's happening. Hey, thanks, Adam. Thanks for hosting. Appreciate that, man. Okay, so we got some wild cinder blocks here. These guys are moving diagonally. Oh, these are the wrong guys. So let's set them up with this other thing. The foes need to be these other foe types. Foes. Ah, here. Okay. So anybody that just joined the stream, this game's called Songbringer. And yesterday's stream, my goal was to create four different types of enemies in one stream. So I'm still on the fourth enemy. That fourth enemy was actually really a doozy because I had to redo a lot of, not redo, but I had to create a new system. Yeah, Portland's really popular. It is a really cool city. If you're interested in traveling the United States or around here, Portland's a rad city. San Francisco's rad. Also, Vancouver, Canada, probably one of my favorite cities in the world. Actually, I love Vancouver. And if you're ever in Australia, I love Melbourne. What's up, Hardline? Thailand's a really neat place. If you haven't been to Thailand, dude, go to Thailand. Awesome people. Okay, so it was complaining about the not being able to read these, but it didn't break, so that's good. I verify that it doesn't break on this system right here. So the next thing to do is to make it so it does run this system for some enemies. And we need to parse the collision flags for that. Nice, right on. Yeah, Adam, thanks, man. I just told you, I said thanks a second ago. Maybe you weren't on the stream yet, but thank you, man. I appreciate that. It is. Yeah, summer's over, but Rocket Bunny likes winter. What's up, Grubuck? Welcome, y'all. Welcome. Okay, so I'm working on an entity type that walks around and around and around stuff. It stays with one of its directions always touching something. So it's always touching. So it's a new system I had to create to be able to detect that. Oh, ads, right? Yeah. Well, thank you again. And now that you mentioned that, next time if it says I'm being hosted, I'll wait a second before saying thanks. What's that? Oh no. Oh, it really is you? All right. Okay, so now this whole function needs to get triggered for any entity that's asking for it. So that is going to be in the collision flags when it creates an entity. So area creation, pathfind. Yeah, this is where it is. Collision. Like input flags. Wait, collision flags? Fire. I don't know if I even ever created these. Did I create any flags for reading these? Dirt, grass, boss, connector, overworld. I don't know if I did. Hey, oh yeah, here we go. K collision types. Where the hell does that get parsed? We're going to need a dictionary word for this. Actually, let's do it right now. There it is. Collision component, parse collision flags. Alright, let's hook this word up then. So this last collision flag is when we want to trigger the touching, tracking the touching. So track touching, K collision, track touching. And this is going to be parse collision flags. Yeah, there you go. Nice, man, nice. All right, man. Good night. Good night. Aha. Okay. It does parse it as part of the collision component. All right. That's fine. We can go at the end of this guy's collision. Oh, now we need a full-on collision statement. What would this be similar to? Jib, sort of. Here we go. Okay, so this thing's category is going to be foe. It collides with, what are all these defaults? Shot friend, shot top at, shot neutral. Size 10.6. What's this last one? Damage 0. Flags. Here we go. Track touching. Now we should hit that breakpoint. Let's see if it does. System. See if the breakpoint. Yeah. So we should get this breakpoint now. This guy should have that flag, but we'll check it if it doesn't work. Yeah, not, oh, what? Damn, didn't work. Okay, let's see if it is working. Good thing. What's this here? I'm sure this is awesome, but does this have music on it? Can't watch it if it has music. Is it daytime? It still is. Robo dude. It's just the bear, the wee hours of twilight. Oh, no music? Nice.
Come on, you guys. There it is, right there in front of you the whole time. You're dereferencing a null pointer. Open your eyes.
Oh, that was awesome. That was awesome. Thanks, Boogie. As usual, man. Okay, what I'm trying to do now is get this guy to parse or to run this method where it updates is what he's touching. So we're getting close. We're getting close to having this guy work. Okay, so first of all, I wanted to turn this back to the triple. Oh, wait, no, that won't create these guys. Let's disable this guy, his sequences that aren't making sense to the system yet. I haven't hooked those words up yet. All right, here we are. These are the enemy types. These are the wild cinder blocks, but they are not triggering that. So what? Let's figure out why they're not getting. Wait, where is that parse collision flags again? There. Size greater than 4? We should be hitting that. Size greater than 4, that'd be 5, right? 5 words? This thing should have 5 words in its, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, this should hit that for sure. So, wait, words 1? This should be words 4. What the hell? I don't know if I've ever tested this line of code. I'm using Cocos 2DX, which uses OpenGL. So here we are inside this method. And yeah, it's totally using the wrong one. Oh my God. Okay, and yeah, I don't think I've ever tested that. Okay, let's check this out. Are there any other places where it would be parsing this, like fire wheat?
Did you want me to put you some lentils on?
Sure. Has fire. Right? I'm trying to decide if I did this on purpose, but I don't think I did. Yeah. This is not on purpose. Yeah. No worries, man. Feel free to ask what you want. Okay, we can unbreak this. There. So now, let's make sure that worked. Size is greater than 4. How did I miss that? I just never tested it. I was like, this'll work, no problem. There, okay. Let's go into this method. Return out. What's our return value? 32768, which should hopefully be track touching. Let's delete this breakpoint, run it, and now we should do that other breakpoint. Yes, we're hitting the breakpoint. It's parsing the touching. Okay, so this current, yeah. All right, let's see if it worked. First of all, this guy should not have anything he's touching yet. So this entity is E, the collision. Flag, we got flags 0, but touching, these are EIDs. These should all be 0. Yeah, okay, so it's not touching anything at this point. Okay, so he's got his current position. It's 331.56. And adding to that current position, right? The current directory. Step into this get pause. South, there we go. We got pause minus equals 1. So now after we get out of here, pause is now 330.155. Good. That should work then. Then it goes and says, okay, I'm touching this entity if we have the collision there. Boom. Done. Okay, let's hook up the systems now. We're ready. This should be working. This might require further testing, but for now, let's hook up the rest of the systems that will make this work. So inside AI system, and when it runs the behavior tree, we need to hook up all these words for touching, last touching, not, clockwise, counterclockwise, and all that. What has been my favorite thing about developing video games? Creating my own worlds. I love, or just what it, creating my own things. Actually, I could just put it with the word creating. I love creating. I'm a very creative person. I love art. I love programming. I love music. And I love doing all those together. I think developing video games is one of the highest art forms we have because it combines so many disciplines, right? You can make art. If you're somebody that can make art, music, and program things, and you can do all those well, you're like a modern day Renaissance man in my eyes. In fact, I look up to people like Thomas Happ, who made Axiom Verge. This guy is amazing. If you haven't played Axiom Verge and you like Metroid, you should go buy this game right now. It's freaking amazing. And this is all made by one dude. One guy made all the art, all the programming, all the music. He got a guy that helped him do the marketing and business and stuff, but he did all that. So I really respect this, and that's what I love most about making video games, is this multiple disciplines coming together. All right, so here in the behavior, let's hook it up. What do we need to hook up? Let's look at this guy's behavior and hook up the words. So let's do this one first. If stuck, that works. Dir clockwise. So we need to do a clockwise direction. All right, so that method we already had, we need to use it. So this lambda function I made in here, this needs to be a function. Modified direction. All right, let's get this compiling. Constants, after touching, we need a function that returns a touching dir. Wait, is that right? Touching dir? System compass clockwise. Oh man, we're gonna need both, right? Yeah, oh man, this is going to need to be two different functions. One, it takes a compass direction, turns it into a touching direction. And then two, we need a function that takes a touching direction and turns it into another touching direction. Is that right? Oh man, this is a really complex guy. I can't believe this is so hard to create this little tiny guy with such a simple, what seemed to be a simple AI. But oh well, I mean, once this is done, it's gonna be very valuable to have, right? This takes a compass direction, returns a touching direction. So if I were to write that out, let's get this written. This is get touching direction from a compass direction. And pull clockwise. And then this is get compass direction. Okay. Compass direction. Given a compass direction? Yeah, given a compass direction, we return a compass direction that which is clockwise or not. Whew. All right. Let's get that compiling. Yeah, No Man's Sky, definitely. Yeah, The Pure Ambition also is very cool, right? Yeah, I watched a little interview with one of the lead guys with that game, and it was really cool. I'm really, really looking forward to what they're creating. I hope it's awesome to play, you know. Do I have any more articles on procedural generation? I already sent you those ones, man. Yeah, I do have one more. What the hell would that be called? Grim Gary sent it to me. I think Grim Gary sent it to me one time. So let me find this article for you. It's on procedurally generating terrain in sort of like a hexagonal. Oh, here's one. Here's one really totally. This is totally procedural. Spelunky is a procedurally generated game. This is like an analysis of how Spelunky's generator works. That's a good one you probably like. By the way, Rocket Bunny's only 12 years old. He's learning your program right now, and he's awesome. How long have you guys, the viewers, been coding? Oh, yeah. He is. Okay, there's one more I got for you, though, Rogue Bunny. Let's see if I can find it. Ah, here it is. Procedural Polygon Map Generator. Yeah, check out this whole website, Red Blob Games. Dude, did they copy Red Blob? No, wait. This can't be right. Why is this on CS Students Stanford? I don't get it. Oh, here it is. Oh, I guess it is. Okay, this is this site too. All right, here you go. Yeah, check that out, Rocket. Grubug, 20 years. Nice, man. We're like brothers. Wait, I don't mean to assume if you're male or female. But yeah, we're like fellows, peers. Nice, man. Welcome to the coding crew. Right? You don't really need to at first, I don't think. Oh, Robo Dude, here's some, nice. You're male? All right, cool. We can be brothers then. Robo Dude, I got a link for you too. Sorry, I don't mean to shove anything down your throat or whatever, but this might be help you because you're just starting out. You're 15 years old. Nice. Check this out. This is a really, really great series from Extra Credits. You might have already come across this, but it's how to start making your own games, you know, from a point of view perspective. But absolute gold. Like every one of these videos in here is amazing, right? This is how to make your first games and lots of videos, lots of advice on this stuff. You know, this is excellent stuff to watch when you're just getting into that kind of stuff. So yeah, I hope that helps, man. Okay, so yeah, great. We got this compiled. Great. Now we need to make that function available for other people to use. This one is, I forget. The evil that is Turbo Pascal. Oh, man. Pascal. Ada. I had to learn Ada in college. I never finished college, but we had to learn Ada in my software engineering college. It was funny. Nobody ever used it after we were forced to learn it. It was a pain. Such a pain to learn Ada. I don't mean to knock on Ada to anybody out there that just loves Ada. Is there anybody that actually loves Ada? Here we go. Now we got a reusable method. Yay. And it's going to be the same kind of thing for get compister. What's up, Bad Mizzle? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, this is C++. Does this have music? Sorry, Robo Dude. I can't click on links if they have music on them, because then they flag my video. Ada. Is Ada high level? Not really. You should forget I ever mentioned it, man. It's not a language people really use today. What's the best way to learn C++? Vlad's gonna probably say the same thing here, but I would start with C. If you really want to learn C++, learn C first. Okay, but you should make the difference, Bat Mizzle, between learning C or C++ or even learning to program in general. Make the distinction in your mind between that and game development. Game development is a lot more comprehensive art form where you're not just programming, but you're also doing art, music, business, and stuff like that. So it really depends on where you want to start. If you really just want to be a programmer, great, learn C. And then move on to C++. But if you want to make games, start playing with game engines, right? Go on and learn game. Go download Game Maker, try it out. Go download Unity, try that out. Try Unreal. Try out a bunch of game engines until you get one you like, and then learn that until you get totally familiar with it. That's my advice on that. So I hope that helps. Oh, it doesn't have music? All right, cool.
Hey guys, and welcome to today's tutorial. In this lesson, I will show you how you can make a simple snake.
Oh, cool, man. Nice. You guys were forced to learn Smalltalk, Prolog, and ML? What's ML? I haven't heard ML. All right, this is going to be a very similar method, this second one here. All right, so bear with me, guys. I'm almost back to running the game. I got to get these couple more methods done and then hook this up to the behavior tree. So, all right, if we got kdir south. East. North. Wow, no loops. Was it a stack? Is it sort of like a stack-based language then, or not stack-based, but like if you push everything and then pop things and stuff to do math? Wow, interesting. Huh. Wow. Allows side effects. Huh. I've never even heard of this. It's cool. All right, this is actually going to be inaccurate, but I really just want to get this done anyway. So what this should be is if it's south and that this entity has allowing movement to the southwest or north or whatever, it needs to be based on what is allowed for that entity. So anyways, I'm just going to move on and just use those as they are. And all right, so modify dir, this one's going to be get touching dir. What up, Toby Peters? Oh. All right, good. We're moving on to AI system behave. And we need to be able to set a direction that's clockwise. So it's gonna be k behavior dir. This is if dir. We want to do the actual behavior direction. Here we go. Okay, this is rand none. We got specific directions. Target opposite south through southeast. All right. Else if subtype equals k behavior. Clockwise, then we're going to change the direction using that new that method there. E.ai.dir equals get compass dir. Given the current direction the entity is moving in, E.ai.dir clockwise, true. Man, this has been a long day of coding just to get this far. Subtype clockwise, counterclockwise. This is false here. There. So that should be able to change those. I'm going to set breakpoints on both these to make sure that they do work as intended. But now we need to hook up the other two behavior things. Right? So we're able to parse that dir clockwise, right? Such a tiny little bit of script. A lot of code to hook up for all that, but we've gone a long ways. So next thing, we need to do these. If last touching and if touching. Dir counter, that should work. Okay, good. So now all we need to hook up now is if touching and if last touching. These are both ifs, they're not sets. You can never set them, so they're just gonna be in the if section of the behavior tree. So back here to ifs. This is all the ifs, right? Yeah, if target is, if rand. Yeah, okay. Currently colliding, count of profile names. Yeah, here. If touching. Subtype equals k behavior touching. Yeah. Yeah. True. This is a good question. Wise, man, wise. Okay, touching. Oh man, touching? Yeah, touching counter, touching clockwise, yeah. Okay, the auto, bool. So we need a bool for not. We'll negate subtype 2. Okay, behavior not. All right, so the next thing we need to get is the actual direction that we need to move in. So dir, it's gonna be the third entity thing. But not if we're negating. Negate, subtype 3, subtype 2. And this should be pretty simple now. After we've got that, all we need to do is call e.collision.touching dir. It's greater than zero. All right, I have no idea if that's gonna work, but let's set a breakpoint and see if it is anywhere near working. In fact, we should also hook up last touching as well so it doesn't break the AI. See you, Robo dude. Okay, I'm gonna set, I got these breakpoints set. Let's see if this behavior actually functions. This is where it's hooking it up. Okay, I need to disable this breakpoint for now. If touching, all right, we're here into if touching. We got subtype 2. Negate, what's negate turning out to be? Negate's false. So the dir is 161. No. Oh, wait a minute. Oh yeah, we don't even need the counter or the counterclockwise behavior thingies. Okay, so I hooked these up wrong. Right? Okay, I don't think I need those. Yeah, there's never ever gonna be an instance where I'm like, oh, that specific, yeah. Right? Yeah, I don't need those. All right. Constants. Yeah. Okay, so we don't need clockwise or any of these to be those, but we do need them to hook up to K touching. think this is correct. Why am I second guessing myself here on this one so much? There. Okay, so this one, we need to convert. We need to convert this, maybe. So. Make sure that's an int. Let's just be specific there. So if it's not clockwise or not counterclockwise, you need to convert that into a touching direction. So gamd equals get touchinger. Yeah, from a compass direction. Oh man, now we need one more method. Damn it. I gotta go hook up another method inside here. Maybe be able to get a touching direction directly from a compass direction without changing it. One more compile. What's up, Ethan? I'm working on an enemy right now. A system for making an enemy walk around and around something. Almost there. Okay, so in constants, I need to hook up this new method for that. Get touching dir from a compass direction. Oh man. This is get compass dir. Right? No, oh no, that's right, yeah. Touching dir, yeah, never mind. Okay, so I need this method. Man, I'm starting to think back on my decision to make a separate touching direction. I think that might have been a bad idea because this is really, really confusing now. Okay, so this has not had anything to do with clockwise. South just becomes K touching south. Man, that is that's crazy. I don't know what to do here. Southwest becomes south or west. Man. Dude, please say I'm almost done with this. D, get touching dir from a compass direction only. It should be int D. So here we need it. Let's test that this is actually a good compass direction. If D is less than or equal to, K num touching dirs and D is greater than zero or greater than or equal to zero. There. Almost ready to run this. Man, so this is the price of hooking, you know, creating. It's just a very simple entity. All this guy's his whole purpose in life is just to walk around and around a wall, keeping a wall on his right or left. It's turning out to be quite a complex thing to hook it up into this, you know, behavior tree and everything. That's the complex part. There's a lot to this. This should be less than. Yes. All right, let's see what happens. Run it. Actually, I want to set the breakpoint before we do that. There. Run that. All right, this guy's testing his direction out. Bool negate and bool and int D. Negate should be false. Great. D is 5. Is that correct? We're looking for the first part of this guy's behavior is if last touching counter. Counter 5? Yeah. 5 is right for counter. Clockwise would be 4. Good. Great, great, great. Okay. So the next step I'm not even using that. Alright, anyways. If D is greater than or equal to 0 and D is less than K num touching DIRS, that should be fine. Good. Return collision touching greater than 0. Okay. That's pretty much okay. We can disable that breakpoint now. Whoa, what the hell happened to the window? What are these guys doing? Are they stuck? They got stuck? You little bastards, you got stuck? After all that work I did? Hi, ho. What's up, Deary? Do you consider to sacrifice one day per week to play other game? You want me to play other games? I do play other games, man, but I'm not gonna do that on the live stream. I'm not a gamer streamer. I'm a game development streamer. My most important thing in my life is creating this game. I want to make a rad game. So yeah, but I have been playing Axiom Verge. I just finished it. It took me 15 hours to finish Axiom Verge. It was the best game I've played since I was a kid. It was so good. Yeah, the sledgehammer crushes it. I like it. Okay, I'm going to disable breakpoints completely and let's see what happens. Mm-hmm. Huh. I think they may have actually kind of worked there for a second, but I haven't hooked up this last bit where it's K behavior last touching. So let's fix that. If subtype equals K behavior last touching, then we're gonna do a different kind of return. This is last touching. Let's run it now. Oh yeah, for variety, yeah. Well, I mean, do you guys really want that? Do you guys want to? Do you want yet another streamer that's playing video games, or do you want to watch game development? I didn't change anything. Well, it's close. You know what I mean? It's getting there. You just want to hang out and talk nonsense? Nice. Good. Right on. You know what? I'm done. I can't code anymore today. These guys, I'll get them working. They're so close, man. This behavior, these touching, this whole system and everything. This is a lot of work. I'm freaking tired already. But, yeah, so that's it for today's stream. My goal is basically to create a guy that will walk around and around a block. So, for anybody that just joined the stream, right? The goal for these gray square cylinder guys or whatever, they're not gonna look like this, of course. I'm just working on behavior. I haven't started the artwork yet for these. But basically, they will walk around and around things. So if they were near this block right here, they would walk around and around and around. If they get to an edge, they should walk around and around that edge, sticking close to it. You know what I mean? That's what these guys are supposed to do. The system is close. I'll fix the system, I'll get it working. So that's it for today's stream, guys. Nice. Bring back Poopy. Alright, you guys. So, yeah, we'll see you tomorrow. That's it for today's stream. Check you later.